Turning motion blur off is going to give you around 1% performance, so do that. Texture filtering is kinda like anisotropic filtering combined with texture quality in one, meaning it basically gives you nothing unless you're hitting VRAM limit. But since there is no visual difference until you get it all the way down to low, I'd say set it to high. With shadows, you won't really be able to tell any difference while playing all the way down to medium. On low, characters stop casting shadows, and a lot of far objects lose them too. So I wouldn't go that low. Set shadows to high, and you're only going to lose some contact shadows, but not all for 3% performance boost. Geometry and vegetation mostly affect smaller vegetation like grass and bushes. High is the best option here, since on medium you start losing patches of grass and geometry slash vegetation pop-in starts being really bad. Environment, from what I can say, mostly affects screen space reflections, where on low it totally turns them off, and the water just looks odd, especially puddles on the ground. On higher setting, you won't really notice any difference, so set it to medium for 4% free FPS boost. Water appears to change displacement map resolution, which doesn't really make a lot of a difference, so I'm suggesting taking it down to high, but if you're still looking for frames, don't be afraid to drop it to low for 8.5% performance without really sacrificing a lot of the detail. Terrain basically always worked a bit like texture, so lowering it almost never gives you any meaningful boost. That's why I leave it on ultra. Volumetric fog in this game isn't consuming frames as bad as in others, but still, there is some performance to gain here, even though in setting, the picture would want you to believe that lowering volumetric fog all the way down is going to look horrible, but I couldn't find a single spot where it would look anywhere nearly as bad. On top of that, during the movement, fog blurs out to the point where difference is barely noticeable. In the end, set it to low. TAA makes the game look as if my screen had Vaseline smeared all over it, so don't use that. If you really prefer anti-aliasing on, then set it to SMAA, but I wouldn't suggest that either, just turn it off altogether for 4% performance boost. I tested this on RTX 3080, since that's the only GPU that actually can do ray tracing. Anything lower than that will just lose too many frames. DXR reflections in this game only affect wet surfaces, excluding big bodies of water, and some more shiny metals, like some car bumpers. But to be honest, screen space reflections are pretty good in this game, considering, so I wouldn't really turn ray tracing reflections on, especially because you lose around 9% performance on RTX 3080 class GPU. Same with ray traced shadows, the difference with them on is so insignificant for the 8% performance loss, so keep it off. Okay, this one is golden. I didn't expect much from AMD's DLSS, thought it's going to just look bad, but I'm positively surprised to the point where I'm actually recommending using it in this game. On 4K screen, you can go all the way down to balance and still keep the game looking good. But my recommendation is simply turn it on and set it to ultra performance for around 27% FPS boost. If you still need more frames, then consider quality for 61% performance. With my optimized preset, this should get around 54% higher FPS compared to Ultra preset. It's going to be better performing compared to low, even though the game looks incomparably worse on low preset.